Welcome everybody to Thought Leadership on Tap. Today we have the pleasure of speaking with Pete Waldroop, who is the CEO of W Energy Software. Pete served as CEO with W Energy Software for the past 10 years, and prior to that, he was founder and EVP at Quorum Business Solutions and was also the original developer for TIPS. Pete, thank you for joining us today. We're excited to have this conversation about creating a customer-obsessed culture. So Pete, we are well into our 20th replacement of legacy plant accounting systems at W Energy Software, and we're starting to see some momentum on the upstream side, and I'm curious why you think that is.
It's a great question for sure. I think clearly we have better software than most of our competitors. That helps. Our software is newer, it's cloud-based, but I don't think that's really the key. I think the key for us and the reason that we continue to win or replace software that's been in place for a lot of years is our focus on customer service and our commitment to it. It starts with me, but it goes throughout the organization. I think everybody understands that in order to be the best provider we can be, we must provide the best possible customer service, and not just at the sale, the point of sale, the point of go live, but throughout the lifecycle of our clients. And we focus on that every day. We invest a lot of money in it. We focus on it. And I think, I really believe that's the reason that we continue to replace our competitors, because what I continue hearing in the marketplace is that clients hear about us, they hear our reputation for customer service, and they're just really excited about it. I think we're different in that regard.
That's great. W Energy Software recently received an NPS score of 47, which for those at home watching is extraordinarily high. And you were surprised by those results. I'm curious why you were surprised by those.
Well, first of all, let me explain what that means. An NPS score of 47, basically the best company in the world is Apple Software, and they're at a plus 70. NPS is plus 100 to minus 100. The worst company in the world from an NPS score that I'm aware of is Comcast, and they're at about a minus 70. So you want to be anywhere above zero is good, right? You want to be on that plus 70 side. Most ERP software platforms rank between minus 5, minus 10. The companies in our space rank usually between minus 30, minus 40, which is pretty impressive. In a bad way. So I think one of the things I expected was maybe we can get in that 5 or 10, maybe we can even be positive. I was surprised, because what it means is our clients want to work with us and tell other people they should work with us as well. And I was just surprised that as hard as we work, and I know we work at every day, I was sort of very pleasantly surprised that our clients appreciate what we do so much.
So, you know, it's clear that you've got a passion for its commitment to the customer. For companies that are trying to build this, you know, customer-obsessed culture, how do you create a team that has that same shared vision and passion as the leadership?
Yeah, you fire everybody that does not have it. You literally weed it out like a cancer. If you look at our folks across the board, they understand this is what we do, and this is what we do well. If you don't like this, if you're not a service-oriented professional, you shouldn't be here. And so, we did have some turnover a lot early on related to this. Now it tends to be people understand it coming in the door. And I think most people really enjoy it. I think they enjoy providing real value to their clients, and I think it grows. But you just have to keep it from the top down. It's a part of your culture, part of every meeting, part of everything you do is, how are we better for our clients? How do we provide the best value for them? How do we do the right thing for them every single day? And as we do that, I think we just get a lot of momentum around it in the culture of the company. And my folks know also that that's more important than a dollar. And it's not always the case in some companies. So they know that if they have to make a decision, they should make the decision on what's right for the company. We'll deal with the dollars later. I'm not as worried about that. I figure that will come.
Do you have a favorite memory of when someone on the team or the company itself went above and beyond for a customer?
So it's Christmas Eve. And because I'm crazy obsessed, like most people, I'm checking my phone just because I have to. And I happen to look down and see an email from one of our clients who says, "Hey, I can't get my plant booked. I know it's Christmas Eve. I'm sorry, but I need some help." So by the time I get on the phone to try to call her, some of my folks from support team are already talking to the person, helping her through it. I couldn't believe it. They're already there. And so we made sure everything got done. She got her stuff booked. She was done Christmas Eve. She got out the door. And it made me feel great, because our folks knew that, listen, helping this client was more important than anything else. And we all want to spend time with our families. We all take that very seriously, but you can't enjoy it if you're not doing the right thing for your clients. And I loved that my guys beat me to the punch of calling her that night. It was really fun.
That's great. That's great. Well, Pete, thank you so much for your time today. I want to do a virtual cheers, and thank you everyone for tuning in.
Cheers.
Cheers.